Hello everybody, and welcome to Ancient Architects. Please subscribe now to get the latest ancient history news and independent research from around the world. Many of you will have seen the news a couple of weeks ago concerning the famous and mysterious stone structure in Hertfordshire, Britain, known as Arthur's Stone, a site that has now been dated to around 3700 BC. The new date means it's older than even the first phase of Stonehenge, but it is of a similar age to the Greater Cursus monument located to the north of the famous stone circle. It's also from a similar time as West Kennet Long Barrow, also known for its large stones. From the recent excavation work, Arthur's Stone is now believed to be part of its own ceremonial landscape right at the start of the British Neolithic. So, what have the archaeologists actually discovered? Well, this site had at least two phases of work. Originally, the stones we see were covered by a mound of earth and compressed turf, with a series of posts to hold it in place. It was a long mound that stretched into a nearby field and was aligned to another nearby site that archaeologists call the Halls of the Dead. Around 200 years later, the mound and the stones were reimagined and they were realigned to the hills much further south. Project leader Julian Thomas said that this area is clearly an ancient ceremonial landscape, just like Stonehenge and Avebury, and was likely a politically or spiritually important centre in the British Isles at the very beginning of the Neolithic. Arthur's Stone actually consists of 9 upright or standing stones, and these support the huge capstone, and this weighs an estimated 25 tons. As we can see, there is a passage underneath, leading to what many believe is a burial chamber. No human remains have ever been discovered though, but because other similar Neolithic structures are associated with known burials, and also because the original burial mound was reimagined, there is a strong likelihood this once was the tomb of an important early Neolithic leader. From the outside looking in, it looks like a lot of effort was needed in its construction, but its appearance is somewhat deceiving. Experts say that instead of stacking the large stone on top of the uprights, it's possible the ground underneath the main rock was simply dug out and then the support rocks were slid underneath. Over the top, the long mound was added, and this was then turfed. As you may have guessed, the site got its name from the legendary King Arthur, who is thought to have resisted the Saxon invasion of Britain around 500 AD. This, of course, is legend, but several historical events have taken place at Arthur's Stone. There was a duel between knights during the Wars of the Roses in the 15th century. Apparently, King Charles dined there with his army during the English Civil War in 1645. It is also the inspiration for the stone table in the Chronicles of Narnia by C.S. Lewis. 1,000 yards from the stone at Dawson Hill is a site known as the Halls of the Dead, a place where a large timber structure was deliberately burnt down in the Neolithic and then replaced by 3 turf burial mounds, which were built onto the footprint of the building. Some speculate that this happened after a tribal leader had died. This was only discovered in 2013, and it's this structure that the Phase 1 long mound of the Arthur's Stone site points towards. This early long mound was surrounded by a palisade of upright wooden posts, which is also seen at the central mound at the Halls of the Dead. Due to the alignment and also the design similarities, these sites were clearly linked around 3700 BC. In time, the wooden palisade would rot, and excavations have shown that the original mound collapsed under its own weight, which is probably why the site was reimagined around 200 years later, but why the orientation was changed we can only speculate. As well as reconstructing the monument itself, Phase 2 saw the construction of an associated avenue of wooden posts. Both the monument and the avenue pointed towards a position between 2 prominent hills, Skirrid Hill and Garway Hill, located 12 miles away in the distance. Therefore, from these later alignments, we can clearly see 2 phases of construction in the early Neolithic. The original mound had a strong relationship with the Halls of the Dead, whilst the second mound, Stones and Avenue, were built to have a relationship with the position between 2 hills in the distance. Through both phases of work though, this specific location clearly had some major importance and prominence. And whether or not this is because there was once a burial underneath, or because it was sacred ground for another reason, or both, we don't know. Even though it's named after King Arthur, it certainly has a history going back much, much further than the legend, and most scholars believe that King Arthur wasn't even a real physical person. The association with King Arthur includes specific marks on the stone, which some say were made by Arthur when he knelt to pray, but others say the marks are indentations of the elbows of a giant that he killed. The site is also said to be the burial place of the legendary king. We can't corroborate any such stories, but archaeologists can now tell us about its development as an early Neolithic site of interest. Its origins date before the first phase of Stonehenge, and it was part of a much bigger ceremonial landscape. But why did it have a relationship with the two hills in the distance? Was there some astronomical significance of this portion of the sky? Did these hills symbolise something to the early Neolithic people of Britain? Was it simply the beginning of a walkway, a trade or travel route? Or did it point to a still unidentified lost settlement? The whole area consists of a number of mounds, a Neolithic causeway and other enclosures, and so Arthur's Stone is just one piece of a much larger puzzle, but no doubt a very important piece. Today, we can only see a fraction of this ceremonial landscape, and it's easy to look at Arthur's Stone and forget that it's not actually some kind of ancient stone table, but is actually the remnants of a stone chamber that was once completely covered over by a mound of earth. During the Neolithic, and even when the mound eroded, revealing the stones, it is likely to have been a site of gatherings, meetings, feasts, and so on, an important and iconic site in Britain. Now, thousands of years later, it may not have the same significance, but it is still one of the most famous ancient landmarks of Britain, and we now know it's 5,700 years old. We still have so much to learn about the ancient history of Great Britain. Only recently, two polished stone balls were found in a 4,000-year-old multi-chambered tomb in the Orkney Isles. 5,000-year-old wooden stakes were also discovered at Orkney's Ness of Brodgar, and now we're finding new information regarding Arthur's Stone, one of the most famous landmarks of ancient Britain. The more archaeologists keep digging, I'm sure the more we'll find out about our ancient past. Thank you very much for watching this episode of Ancient Architects. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel, please like the video, and please leave a comment below. Thank you very much.